Another useful tool in AutoCAD is the offset tool. Contrary to the copy tool, which creates clones of objects at a specified distance and direction, offset creates a new object whose shape is parallel to the shape of the original object. In the first example, I am going to show you how to create parallel lines and curves, as well as concentric circles with the offset command. The offset command can be found either in the Modify menu or in the Modify panel of the Home ribbon. Once it is active, the first thing I need to do is specify the offset distance. So I will type the number 30 and press Enter to move on to the next step. Next, I have to select the object I wish to offset, so I will click on the line. Then, a message appears which prompts me to specify the side which the parallel shape will be created. While moving the cursor, the preview changes accordingly. When I click on the side I want, the parallel line is being created, but the command does not deactivate. I can select the next shape I wish to offset, which is the curve, and click to create another parallel shape. Finally, I will click on the last shape of this example, which is the circle, and notice that the distance field is active in case I want to change the distance of the offset. Since I wish to create a concentric circle 40 units apart, I will move my cursor inside the existing circle to specify the side, type the number 40, and press Enter. Once I no longer wish to offset the shape, I will press Enter or Escape to deactivate the command. In the next example, I will show you the difference using offset on polylines and individual lines. The first shape is a polyline, so every linear segment is part of the same object. On the contrary, the second shape is not a polyline. They are three independent lines that create a similar shape. Let's see how creating a parallel shape of those two works. I will activate the offset command and set the distance to 35. Then, I will move my cursor to the upper side of the polyline and click to create a parallel shape. Now, I will proceed to do the same to the similar shape right below. However, this time, I have to select each line separately, specify the offset side, and click to create the shape. In the end, the result is nowhere near the first shape, and that's to be expected since I created the parallel lines of three individual lines. The same thing happens with shapes like rectangles and polygons, which are by default polylines. When I use offset on a rectangle, as you can already see, a parallel rectangle is being created. Although, when I use offset command on lines, even if they form a rectangle, the result is not the same. Lastly, I would like to show you how you can easily draw a pipe corner with the offset tool. So, in the last example, I am going to recreate the pipe corner which can be seen on the left. I'm going to activate the offset command and specify the distance as 20. Then, I will select the arc that represents the outer side of the pipe, move the cursor to the right, and click to create the arc that represents the inner side of the pipe. Next, I will select the same arc again, move the cursor to the right, and change the distance's value to 100. I will press Enter. Select the same arc again, move the cursor to the right, and increase the distance to 120. I will press Enter twice to create the last arc and exit the command. As you can see, the pipe corner is finished.